Hello, in this video, I'm going to install Leviton timer switch. This model comes with 5, 10, 15, 30 minutes. But you can change this to other settings as well. I will show you how to do it after installation. If you press the bottommost button, you can turn off the power anytime you want. At the back, there are a few wires, hot wire, neutral wire, ground wire. This is a load wire. I will show you where to connect this in a bit. This is for three-way installation. The sticker says not to remove this if you don't use three-way switch. Of course, you should not cut the wire either. I'm going to replace this fan switch here, because like millions of people out there, I keep forgetting to turn it off. Before doing anything, I will turn off the power from the panel box. I'll remove this switch cover first. This is the fan switch, so I will unscrew this. And the same thing for this light switch. All these wires could be a bit overwhelming and confuse you. But don't worry, let me help you understand with a few diagrams. This is a panel box, and this is a light. To turn on the light, we will have wires connected. This is good, we have our light working. The electricity will leave panel box and go to the light through hot wire and turn on the light. Then go back to the power source, which is the panel box, through neutral wire. But if we leave it like this, the light will stay on all the time, which doesn't really make any sense. So a switch will be installed. With this switch, we can turn on or turn off the light. Depending on the electrical code of your area, you might have the ground wire not connected to the switch. You will need to check this yourself. Now, if we have a fan installed, it will be more like this. With these two switches, we can control them separately. I'm going to remove this switch here and install timer switch. But this one comes with four wires. You remember the red load wire from the timer switch? This load wire needs to be connected to a hot wire coming from the fan. But if you remember, there are two exactly same black wires connected to the switch. One is coming from the panel box, the other is coming from the fan. So how do we know which one is which? We need to make sure we make the right connection, otherwise the timer switch will not work. This is when we use a non-contact voltage tester. Let me go back to the panel box and turn the power back on. If I bring this tester to a wire, and it makes loud beep sound and red light, that means it's hot, which means the electricity is running. If it's quiet and green, that means there is no electricity running. If you look here, all the switches are off, but the tester beeps with red light. That means that this wire is hot. So this must be coming from the panel box. This one is also hot, connected to the fan switch. Let's find the hot wire from the fan now. As you can see, this wire is not hot right now, but if I turn the switch, the wire becomes hot and the fan runs. This shows you that this wire is a hot wire coming from the fan. Same goes for the light as well. This is hot wire from the light. Now we know what is what, we can continue installing the timer switch. I will go back to the panel box and turn off the power again. Don't forget this, make sure you work safe. This wire is connected to push-in connector. If you look at the bottom of the connection, there is a small hole. You can put a small stick and push hard, then the wire will come loose. Before I forget, I'm going to mark the hot wire from the panel box with this electrical tape. I don't really need this cover, so I'm going to remove this. I should install my ground wire to that green screw there, but I think I can use these wire connections that real electricians made already. Just so you know, I love DIY, but I'm not a real electrician. So if you find I'm doing something wrong or could do better, please let me know in the comment section below. I'll do the same for the neutral wire as well. This hot wire is a little short, so I'll use my wire stripper to make it longer and connect. I wrap the connections with electrical tape just to make sure these don't come loose when I clamp in all the wires in this tiny box. The connections are complete. Let's see if everything is working before putting them all back in. Back to the panel box. Okay, the light turns on. I see a light in the timer switch. This is a good sign. Fan works as well. Both works well. This is great. I love this tester and I'm still amazed by it. Really cool. Back to panel box again. Now, time to put everything inside the box. Very tricky. I don't want to screw the switches too tight just yet. It might not fit with the cover, so I need to test first. Yep, it doesn't fit. I will move the timer switch a little. There you go, perfect fit. Awesome. For the last time, I'm back to panel box and turn on the power. Everything is working as expected. Let me show you how to customize these times now. By default, it's 5, 10, 15, and 30 minutes. If you want to change this to something else, press and hold first and third button. If you hold it, you will see this orange light first, then it goes to green. Then whatever is activated will be flashing in green. All you need to do is look at this chart and choose whatever you want. For me, I want short times, so I will choose fourth option, which is 2, 5, 10, 15 minutes. Press fourth button and press the bottom button, then it will save your choice. I've tested the first button. Mine becomes 2, 4, 8, 12 hours. Let's see if it saved my choice. Press first and third button together and hold. Yep, fourth button flashes. My choice has been saved as expected. Installing a new switch could be a bit confusing and overwhelming with all the wires. But I hope my video gave you some ideas and help you understand it better. If you are interested in tools that I used in this video, please check the affiliate links down in the description. This is it from me for this video. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button, give it a thumbs up, and leave a comment. It will help grow this channel. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye!